Societally, there's a great public interest in improving cryptography on the internet. The Snowden leaks have shown us that there's a lot of information being observed by unintended parties. There's a lot of engineering effort going on right now in improving security protocols with new designs that are more efficient and provide better security properties. I think the most important challenge for information security in the coming years is ensuring there's a connection between the engineering community and the academic community. The engineering community is building new designs, improving efficiency, designing new products that do good things for consumers, and the academic community needs to be involved in that, making sure that the designs are cryptographically sound and trying to bring in some new exciting ideas from cryptography as well. We can do more, and we can do more for the engineering community. Our internet communication is protected by a protocol called SSL, Secure Sockets Layer. This is the lock icon you see in your web browser when you try to enter your credit card number or password on a website. And behind this lock icon are a lot of algorithms. There's a cipher which scrambles the information so people can't read it. There's a public key which verifies the identity of the website so you know that you're really communicating with Google when you try to log in. And there are a bunch of other cryptographic algorithms, all of which have to be secure in order for the communication to actually be private. One of the biggest accomplishments in the field of applied cryptography in the last 5 to 10 years has been the adoption of new algorithms. We've seen new ciphers, new hash functions, and new public key primitives like elliptic curve cryptography. So that's been a huge advance. On the academic side, we've made a huge breakthrough in the past few years in our ability to analyze real-world protocols. They're more complex than academic protocols, but we're finally able to model them and understand what their security properties actually are. There are several challenges to transitioning to quantum-safe cryptography. First, we need quantum-safe primitives and we need to have confidence in their security, especially the cryptographic parameter sizes that we use in these algorithms. Second, we need the engineering community to adopt these. And that's a particularly big challenge because they need to be convinced of the need to adopt these new algorithms before they're actually needed. We need our communications now to be secure against computers that haven't been invented yet and might not be around for 20 or 30 years.